Hey guys, Matt Kentucky Range Time back with another episode in our 50 cal ballistic gel block testing. In this episode, we're looking at the Hornady bore driver ELDX in the 340 grain. And this is a big old massive bullet. It's got the ELDX polymer tip in it. It's got the bore driver base down here. And it's a 50 caliber bullet. So, you know, just a big old chunk of lead and copper. So let's turn around and take a quick look at the loading, and then we'll head on out to the range.
All right, so Winchester 209 primers, the Hornady bore driver bullets, and the Pyrodex 50-50. And what the 50-50 is, that's 50 caliber and 50 grains of powder per pellet. And we will be running a 3-pellet load, a 2-pellet load, and a 1-pellet load with these bore driver bullets. And getting velocities for each one of those with the Garmin Zero Pro C1. And here's a quick look at how Hornady packages these bullets up. So there's 12 bullets in this pack. There's four tubes of three bullets each. And these are the quick tubes that Hornady puts these in, which can be pretty neat if you want to pull one of these out and throw in a little side pouch or something while you're out hunting. So, all right, guys, let's get out to the range and see what this thing does.
All right, guys, next up is the Hornady bore driver 50 cal, 340 grain bullet. And I'll be running this with a 3-pellet charge, a 2-pellet charge, and a single pellet charge. And one thing I want to note here, I picked up some of this Brim Shiner, and it's grease and lubricant for black powder guns. You can use it in your bore, use it on the outside, use it basically anywhere you want. And what I'm doing with this is I'm putting a really light coating of that around the plastic skirt on these bullets. It makes these things much easier to seat out here with the ramrod. And just a little hack here that one of my buddies at work told me about a while back. So anyway, big shout out to Rusty for that little tip. And I've already got a 3-pellet charge loaded up here, ready to go. So let's get a primer in this and see what it'll do. Now, I've got the velocity captured here on the Garmin, and I've got clean gel block out there. The front block is, it's been reheated 5 or 6 times, so it's fairly clear. We should be able to see a really good look at the permanent wound track, and I've got a new camera doing the slow motion camera work, so hopefully everything will line up here and we'll get a good complete set of data. Velocity of 1568.3. We got pretty much a center mass hit on the gel block. Let's go down and see if we got a catch. All right, guys, this is the 340 grain bore driver ELDX bullet from Hornady. And look at that massive polymer tip up there. You know, that's a pretty impressive polymer tip on there. And I guess to get the expansion at these lower velocities, that may be what it takes here. So look here, we've got a nice permanent wound channel here. Looks like that bullet was doing a lot of flipping and tumbling as it went through here in that 3 to 8 or 9 inch area. Penetration started slow. Looks like we're getting good penetration started around 2 inches, full penetration around that 3 to 4 inch mark, and big chunk of copper there and several decent sized fragments of lead, and nice big chunk of bullet down here at about 20 1/4 inches. And looks like that's got a really nice mushroom head expansion on this thing. So, all right, guys, that was a 3-pellet load. Let's go back and put the 2-pellet in here and see what it does. All right, I wanted to grab a quick look at this wound channel from the top side here. From this angle, the wound channel looks a little bit more substantial on this permanent wound channel, and I'm sure the temporary wound cavity was also very large as well. All right, guys, All right, guys, up next is the two pellet load with the 340 grain bore driver ELDX bullet from Hornady. We did not get a velocity with that one. Let's go see if we got the catch. All right, this wing channel right here on the bottom is from the two pellet load. We did not get a catch with that one. It came down here and exited right about the same place where the three pellet load stopped. And I didn't get velocity either, so we'll go back and reshoot this one. All right, guys, this is the 340 grain Hornady bore driver ELDX repeat of the two powder charge. I did not get a velocity or a catch with the first one. Again, no velocity. Let's go see if we got a catch with this one. All right, guys, we did get a catch with this one, and this is our wound channel right here, right below the three pellet load. The other side of the block had the first two pellet shot. Expansion is almost identical. Maybe a little bit smaller permanent wound channel here, but the temporary wound channel and everything tracks down. The polymer tip came out in a similar format as this is the two pellet and this is the three pellet. I don't see as many big lead chunks, but there is some copper here. Looks like a big lead chunk right here at 16 inches and then straight line penetration down here to about 21¾ inches. And that was the two pellet load. I did not get a velocity on this shot. I'll go back off camera and shoot that velocity here in a few minutes. Let's go back now and do the one pellet shot. All right, guys, next up is the one pellet charge of PyroDex 5050 with the 340 grain bore driver ELDX bullet. And let's see if we can get a catch and a velocity with this one. I want to shoot for really low with this one. And no velocity again. Let's see if we got the catch. Guys, so wound track for this single pellet load starts right here, and we go in about 5 inches, and doesn't look like we're getting a lot of expansion, and then it looks like this bullet flips over. We lose the polymer tip. We get a little bit of action on the bullet at that point. See a shard of copper there. Right at 15½ inches, looks like it bounces off the table and then comes back up, and final penetration out here about 22½ inches, and doesn't look like we got a whole lot of expansion on this bullet. Maybe just a little bit. We'll have to dig it out later and take a look. So, all right, all three bullets with the three pellet, the two pellet, and the one pellet all have ended up here in about the same spot. All right, guys, so here's the results, and this is the one pellet, the two pellet, and the three pellet charge. And here's a look at the bore driver base on this bullet. This weighs 10 grains, and
You know, this is advertised as a 340 grain bullet, but with the bore driver skirt on it, this actually weighs in at 350 grains. This is 10 grains. These polymer tips are about 16 grains each as well, but they are included in the 340 grain weight advertised on the package. Now, the expansion we got on these was pretty significant. This is the 3-inch, and here is the 2-inch. Get a good look at those. Good expansion on these at their velocities. And the one pellet charge was a little bit different. So this bullet actually went down and skimmed off the bottom of the table. And a lot of this damage came from the bottom of the table. And actually, the number listed for penetration for this bullet is probably low, because I'm sure when it hit the bottom of the table, it stole several inches off of its penetration. This may have been out there in the high 20s, maybe even close to a pass-through if it had not hit the table. So, and retained weight, well, that might be another question. Lots of big chunks of lead out here, lots of big slivers of copper. If you look over here, you can see that this polymer tip actually extends way down into the case. Not a lot of lead between the copper and the ballistic tip. And that allows for all these big petals of lead and copper that are coming off of here. So, these are going to shed quite a bit of weight. So that's something to keep in mind. Once these things do hit, they will be shedding weight. So,
all right, guys, the Hornady bore driver base ELDX bullet, 340 grain. This was the expansion on the two pellet charge. And this is good expansion. This is the expansion that, if you go to look the ballistics chart that I have attached coming up here in the slideshow, you'll see that this expansion is what you would get out of a three pellet load out just past 50 yards. And then, of course, the expansion, we had basically no expansion other than the damage from impacting the table to the one pellet charge. And that would have been maybe even a shoot through if it hadn't gone down and hit the table. But the equivalent to that is 150 yards. The expansion we got, the velocity we had off the one pellet load, basically lets us know that even a three pellet load that starts out with nice expansion is probably not going to expand out past 150 yards. And expansion is probably going to be degraded somewhere between 100 and 150 yards. The other big factor with this bullet is at 15 yards, this three pellet shot lost 40% of its original weight. So this thing shed a lot of lead, it shed a lot of copper jacket, lots of active fragments and lots of side bleeding channels, which is not a bad thing. And we still got decent penetration out of this. Similar story with the two pellet load. So I guess what I'm getting at is this is a good bullet, but I'm not sure that you're going to get the performance out of this bullet at extended distances that Hornady's advertised on the package, at least not out of my 22-inch barrel. Now, if you got a Magnum rifle with a 28 or a 30-inch barrel, yeah, you might be knocking these things out to 200, 250 yards, but in the configuration that we've tested it, that's just not what we're seeing. So, anyway, I think these manufacturers are really hyping up all the new muzzleloader bullets these days, trying to make them sound like they're going to get you the same performance that the centerfire rifles are getting. And I just don't think we're there yet, not with black powder. So, if you've got any questions, please leave those in the comments. I'd be glad to hear any feedback. If anybody's actually used these, has some firsthand experience, that would be excellent to hear some of that feedback. And if not, I appreciate you guys watching. If you haven't already, please hit that like and subscribe button. And I have four more videos coming up behind this one. Two of those are running all lead bullets. And guys, I think one of those two lead bullets may be
the best bullet I've tested. I'll have 9 bullets when this series is complete. I think I have an all lead bullet that may check all the boxes for expansion and penetration. So stay tuned for that one. Got you, Donna. Anyway, I'll catch you guys on the next one.